How to create clickable bubble links. This video will show you how. So when I click on this bubble here, instantly a link opens with a specific website. And if I click on this one, another link opens up with a different website. So they're connected through a specific link. So let's explore how to do this. So let's start to look how to create a clickable bubble chart in Chartjs. First up, what we need to do is we need to get our boiler template, which you can find here on chartjs3.com getting started. And this link you can find as well in the description box. So once you're on here, copy this boiler template here. Copy this. And if you want to understand this code, make sure you watch this video here that explains it all. Put it all in there. And then let's cut out the title, put the title in here. Save, refresh. All right, so now we have this. What I want to do is I want to convert this into a bubble chart. So, let's maximize the size of it, say 80% first, to maximize the bubble chart shape or the chart itself, and then scroll down here and convert this into a bubble chart, save, refresh. All right, so now we have a bubble chart axis or structure, but of course we're still missing a few items. So in here in the data, I will only use two data points. That'll be more than sufficient. So I'm going to say enter, enter, and then in here we have the X. And for the X, let's say here 18. And then we have the Y, and that can be 6. And then we have the radius, and that could be maybe 10 pixels. So then what I want to do is I want to copy this, put a comma here, paste that in there. Say this one will be 6, and this one will be 12, and this one will be 6 as well, and this should be 12 as well. Save, refresh. All right, so now we have these numbers here, and 2 should be more than sufficient for our example. So what I need to do now is I need to put in a link here, I want to put in links. When we click on this red dot, we should get a response. And if we click on this blue dot, we should get another link being redirected. So to do this, what I need to do is I need to create a function, and this function we can just call our click bubble. And then our parameter would be the click itself. So this is basically the click event that we're going to track. So if I do here console log, we should see a click, save, and then of course right now it doesn't activate yet. So what we need to do is we want to register it, maybe click on the canvas. And the canvas is basically just the CSS, the HTML here above. That is this one here, the canvas tag. So what I'm going to do here, I'll just say here, first of all, I get the my chart object, which is basically the chart object here, a constant. And then I say here dot canvas. And basically what I'm really saying here is go into this ID and track the canvas tag itself. And when we click on this, so on click, when we click on this, what I want to do is trigger the click bubble function. Very straightforward. If I refresh now, open up the console log, and if I click somewhere, you can see it registers the pointer and understands what is happening exactly. And what exactly happens is it clicks on what exactly the target, what is our target, the canvas with the ID name of my chart. So you can see it highlights that item here nicely. All right, so now we have this, but I want to go more specific because I want to track if I click on this dot or on this dot or bubble. So, and I can see here, sorry, my bad, I have this misspell, that's horrible. Make sure I do this correctly. All right, so now what I want to do is I want to change this. I'm going to say a constant, and I'm going to track the points. So I say your points will be equal to my chart dot, and this is a built-in Chartjs functionality. So get elements at event for mode. And basically what we're saying here is go, when we click on the chart object, get the elements that is being triggered at an event. And what event are we tracking? Basically the click event here. And I'm giving this a name of click, but it's this is the official click trigger. This is just a parameter, remember that. So that's the difference. So, but basically there it's a reference to the click. So we say, if we click, what I want to do is I want to go and find the nearest position. And then we talk about here, or then we do here, curly braces, intersect. And if it intersects equals true, in that case, show this data. All right, so what I mean by intersect, intersect is just when I hover over it, you can see here, the moment you see the two appearing, it means that my pointer intersects or is within the radius of the bubble. That's the intersection. All right, so now we have that. What I want to do here now is, of course, I want to get the details. So I say here, if points, which is basically this one here, has a length, dot length. If that is the case, console log the points, save. All right, so if I now click here, you can see here we get the points, but it will show here just some basic information. But if I click on this, you will see now we get something more. We get the details, and more specifically, which dot I have clicked on. But if I click on the white space, we don't have the information. If I click on the blue one, you can see here, we get this array with the information beautifully. All right, now you can see here even the data set index, which is the data set number, and of course the index number or the element, which is index number one, because this is the second element. This is the first element, index zero. All right, so now what I want to do is I just want to grab those two data points because they are very important for me. So what I want to do here now is, well, we can say here, constant data set index, which data set are we in? Well, basically we are on data set number one. So I'm going to say points, index zero, which is fine because if there's a length, then it shows, and there's a length of one item. So there's one element being selected. So in that case, it's index zero. And then we say you just get the data set. So what I want to grab is the data set index. All right, so that's number one. So the next thing is constant. And what I want to get here is basically the data point. I want to know on which element am I clicking? Am I clicking on the first element or the second one in that data set? So what we can do here, how we get this information, you can see your index, that's the one. So basically the same here, just copy all of this. Just say here index with small letters because it is here. Index is a small letter. All right, so now we have this, and if I just do here now console log, and we can just show this, or yeah, well, I guess we can show this. And then what I want to do is plus the data point. Oh, and I guess what I need to do is a dollar sign. I'm going to just backtick. So I'm going to have just a advanced concatenation here. That's maybe easier. There we say and dollar sign. And this put it in this variable, save, refresh. So if I click now, you see here I get index zero and data point zero, which is correct. And this should be index zero and data point one. All right, works, it's all now confirmed. So let's remove this, we don't need this anymore. Now what I want to do is I want to put in the link. So I'm going to say your window dot open. And then here what we can say is grabbing a link. So let's do here first a hard-coded one, www.chartjs3.com, my personal website. And then what I want to do is comma, and then here underscore blank opening a new tab. So if I save this right now, refresh, if I click on this, it automatically opens a new tab, Chartjs3. All right, if I click on this one, it does the same website, of course, because we have hard-coded the website links. Now, what I want to do is soft-code them. So how do we soft-code them? And this is the reason why I have this prepared here. This will be very important. Let's go up here. In here, I'm going to create a new object name or namespace. And I'll say this is the link. And this link will be https://www.chartjs3.com. And the other one, we're just going to grab this, put a comma here, and this will be link chartjs.org. Save, refresh. Now, of course, nothing happens yet because I need the reference to this link. So how do I do this? Well, this here needs to be adjusted. And how we can do this is quite simple. We can say here, remember we have these points here that gives us the data set and the element. So I say here constant link equals, let's see here, what we can do is my chart. And basically what I'm doing is this my chart object, my chart here. Then we go to data, and from data, we go to the data sets and then data. So let's do that first. My chart dot data dot data sets index zero. And then here the data, and this should be then of course index zero. And then here eventually, because that's, if we do index zero We have the hard code, but then later on we were just going to soft code them. And we have here the link at the very end. All right, so once we have this, if I copy this, it will be hard coded here. But remember, this here, we already soft coded them here. So let's save this first and see if this link truly works. So if I refresh, and I guess here, this will be the site, we can just leave it like that. And if I click on this one here, it goes to Chartjs 3, as you can see here. So that is confirmed. But what I want to do now is soft code this by saying dataset, index will be in here, and data point is here. Save, refresh. Now if I click on this, we go to chartjs.org, and if I click on this one, we go to chartjs3.com. Absolutely phenomenal, and that is basically how we can create a clickable link on the bubble elements in Chartjs. So if you enjoyed this video and maybe you want to know even more things or do even more items, for example, having different shapes, in that case, I'm going to recommend you this video here on how to create bubble chart with different style point shapes in Chartjs, where you can see triangles, circles, rounded rectangles, and star elements. That's also another way how you can make a different data set having different shapes. Very useful as well.